Hey everyone, we're here on Next Island still, and today I thought we would just do the daily, and then we'll switch over to EP1 just to finish out the skill pool we're going to use for the daily, because we don't get a lot of textiling done, and so I really want to capitalize on the skill gains if we can. And so we're up here at Tanzanite, what's it called? Tanzanite View? Yep. And May over there is the daily. It's going to give us 40 peck in textile engineering, I think it is, for doing this lesser Elysium blueprint right here. And we have to get 50 successes. I think it takes us about 120 times to get there, but let's take that skill pill I was talking about. There we go. Because we definitely want to capitalize on the skills that are going to be thrown down, like the tailoring. We don't get a lot of tailoring. Then hopefully we'll generate a blueprint or two as well. And that lesser Elysia is used on Next Island for a handful of things, is my understanding, including a quest. And so we'll stockpile some of that back for when we want to do one of the VIP quests. I want to say it's the new Elysian Order one, but I'm not 100% sure on that. I'm just trying to pull that back from memory from like a couple months when we looked it up. And you can see we're not amazing on success rate either. Our blueprint is still pretty low. And then our skills in regards to this is also kind of on the pretty low side. And so we're just doing this to get our textile ling up a little bit. Like I said, I think it's. Let's see if it tells us. It doesn't. I'm pretty sure it's texture engineering, this one. This skill right there is, I think, what we'll get at the end. But along the way, we'll get some tailoring and some other textile skills. At least potentially, we're doing a pretty small run, 120 clicks or so. But with our skill so low, we get skill ups a little faster, and so we're gonna hope. Yeah, see, material extraction, texture engineering, some regular engineering, and the fact that these are like 26 pack per click, I think 24. And skills are definitely tied to the cost that you put through yourself a little bit. And so the combination of the 24 pack per click and the low skill, you see we're starting to definitely got more skill ups than we're going to get when we run the EP1. But so far, we're off to a pretty rough start. You see, we're pushing on 50 clicks, and we're at 16 successes. Which I guess is a little under 40%, which is kind of where we'll be once we're fully qualified. That 40 to 42% is what I see a lot on like the EP1 and the EP2 and stuff. But yeah, our success rate's going to be low. This is just us kind of buying skills a little bit. And it gives us something to do with all the sweat that we sweat. It's 20 sweat per click on this, so we go through 1 to 2,000 every time we want to do the daily. But when we're not doing a big hunt, a lot of times we like to swamp, and we have like a mob on every planet, right? On Tolan, we try to stick to those tabs. Low hit points. They drop stuff that has reasonable return. The hides and the extractors are both over 150%. On next island, we like to do the Cyclops. We can do the baby boars and like yellow papu, like the young ones, I think it is. And so we have a few options. Oh, there we got a blueprint. Prancer leather texture. On Cyrene, we do those weak Panaleans. On Calypso, you got the terps. And then the sweat circle if you want to go that route. On Rocktopia, you got all sorts of stuff. The forum trolls, the green-haired ones have 50 hit points. The blue-haired ones have 200. The sweaters, the haters have 300. Those are some great options. The city wolves have 50 hit points for the young ones, and the ones out at that old wolf creek drop like all those grindhouse records that have a little bit of markup. On Arcadia, you got the Karabok and the Gallard. As far as solo like swantable mobs, pretty early. Yeah. I think that's about it. Monoria doesn't really have much. They got those 10 to 12 hit point shubs. That's it. So that's just a way to kind of does swanting does two things, and why I like it. One, it's really laid back. You're just kind of kicking it for a second while you gather the sweat. That allows you to go get a beverage. Or whatnot. Two, you're not constantly killing, so it stretches out how fast you're going through your ammo. That's especially important if you have a low ped card, which I've had for most of my career on this game, where I have almost no money. And so, plus. You get about roughly, they say 90% returns, right? If you take the sweat on top of the returns, it slows how fast you bleed out ped, or potentially brings you into the near break-even zone. And so you lose less ped, and it takes you longer to lose that less ped, is all. It's no different than if you're like, I went for a hunt, and then I went to the sweat circle for a while. That's less fun, I feel, but whatever works. Like, you have to get enjoyment from it. And so, like, if you'd rather swant, do that. If you'd rather just hunt and then go to the sweat circle or go do whatever you do to make a little bit. Oh, and there we've hit our mark. Let's run, go get our reward here real fast so we can see that. So I can nail down, I think it says texture engineering, but I kind of forgot. Oh, it's make textile. Okay, so it's make textile. I was absolutely mistaken. Now, because we got a little bit of this, oh, that's not what I wanted. We got 50 minutes or so. We're going to go ahead and put that down for about 600, I think is about 45 minutes. So we'll go ahead and click that up. We're going to run this. Hopefully, we're going to generate some blueprints. Let's see if we got anything besides that one blueprint from the. We did not. It was the only blueprint we got. That's a bummer. Anyway, we're going to use this to keep capitalizing on the skill pill that we took and see if we can't generate some sort of blueprint. That's hopefully next island specific. We're gonna let her go. Let's see what happens. that puts the end of our little crafting run here. Kind of struck out on blueprints today, which is kind of a bummer. Statistically, we're still in the normal zone we would expect to be in. In fact, we're up about half a ped. Oh, I didn't see we generated a system stabilizer. Let's take a look at that. NI components. Let's see if we got that book. I got a lot of books. I don't think I do have the next island component book. We might have to get that. Interesting. Anyway, we generated the system stabilizer as well, which is kind of neat. I hope that everyone is having an amazing day. Stay epic.